إن الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله اللهم صل على أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن عليا ولي صلى على محمد وعلى أشهد أن عليا حجة الله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم اجعل قلبي بارا وعملي سارا وعيشي كارا ورزقي دارا وأولادي أبرارا وجلدي عند قبر نبيك محمد مصطفى صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم مستقرا وقرارا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله كما هو أهله الحمد لله على كل نعمة وعلى كل حال الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين إنه خير ناصر ومعين نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونشكره ونصلي ونسلم على حبيب إله العالمين حافظ سره ومبلغ رسالاته الرسول المسدد المصطفى الأمجد المحمود الأحمد أبي القاسم محمد وبآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين صلوات الله عليهم أجمعين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم من الأولين والآخرين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين. أما بعد، سلام عليكم جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی says in Quran Majid, in Surah Al Imran, which is the third chapter of Quran Majid, verse number 31, that in kuntum tuhibbun Allah fattabi'uni. If you love Allah, then Prophet is commanded to say this to the people. So Prophet says that if you love Allah, in kuntum tuhibbun Allah fattabi'uni, then you follow my footsteps, the footsteps of Rasulullah. You follow me, fattabi'uni. Yuhibbukum Allah wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum. Then what will happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. Yuhibbukum Allah wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all your sins. Wallahu ghafurur rahim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is oft forgiving and He is merciful. Now when we say muhabbat, then the concept of mawaddat also enters in. Mawaddat, when we love a person or when we love our children, our family, our parents, this is called muhabbat. And then mawaddat, the difference between muhabbat and mawaddat is that love which is wajib on you, that is mawaddat. Yani it is necessary and compulsory for you to love those personalities. Kulla as'alukum alayhi ajran illa al-mawaddata fil qurba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have used mahabba fil qurba, but no, he uses mawadda. Il kulla as'alukum alayhi ajran illa al-mawaddata fil qurba. If you want to pay, tell them that I do not demand any recompense, any salary for my services which I am giving to you. But the salary which you have to give me back is love towards my family, towards my near ones. So that love which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has demanded and commanded to Prophet, that tell them that they should give that love, that is mawadda. And that is ajra risalat. It is very important that we need to have that mawadda for the family of the Prophet. Now, sometimes you could love anybody, a pet. Even muhabbat can be even with a pet at home, with a cat, isn't it? It's your pet, you could love it, isn't it? That is muhabbat. But when muhabbat becomes wajib, it is mawadda. Even in وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا ثُمَّ جَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. There also Allah uses mawadda. He says, from his signs, amongst his signs, there is one sign that he has created soulmates for you, your spouses for you. Then he has inspired mawadda wa rahma. There also he uses the word mawadda. But mawadda, which we are commanded by Allah to show for Ahlul Bayt, it is a high level, a high degree of love. And when we do mahabbat, when Imam Sadiq was asked, what is this mahabbat? It is very, Ahlul Bayt were taking this concept very seriously. When Sixth Imam was asked, what is this mahabbat? Sixth Imam said, mahabbat yani itaat. He says, when you love a person, and who is your role model should be Ahlul Bayt. When you love them, then you follow them. When you love them, you obey them. That is why to some extent Imam Bakir says, la karabata bainana wa bainakum illa bitaqwallah. There is no relation between you and me except taqwa of Allah. Except you fear Allah, then you can say that I'm related to you, I'm your Imam, Imam Bakir says. So again, when Imam Sadiq was asked, what is this mahabbat? What is this mawaddat which has come in Quran? Imam Sadiq said, this mawaddat is ita'at. You obey us. When you love a person, when you make him your role model, when you love your teacher, example, you have been with him for a long time, he has been teaching you, and you have liked him because of his hikmah, because of his wisdom, because of his knowledge, because of his practicing, because of his amal, then what will happen? You will start to imitate him because you love him. So Imam Sadiq says, you follow us, you obey us, you follow our footsteps. This is mawadda, which is ita'at. In the time of Rasulullah, when Rasulullah was leading prayers, a person entered in. When he was entering in, it was the time of Zuhr. And the Prophet was about to stand for Namaz Zuhr to lead Salah. And a person comes and he says, Ya Rasulullah, I have a question. In Safinatul Bihar, Allama Majlis brings this small incident, and I end up my khutbah. the first khutbah. He says that, I have got a question. Rasulullah says that we all have stood for prayers. Let me finish my Zuhr Salah. Then you pose your question. When they finished their Salah, and then when Rasulullah recited Salam, and then Rasulullah himself, he was very humble to that extent that the Muarrikhin and the historians say that people would not know who is Muhammad. If he would sit amongst the Muslims in the circle of the Sahaba and the companions, Rasulullah was so humble that people would ask, Aina Muhammad? Where is Rasul? Maybe this Arab Bedouin knew Rasul because Rasul was standing in mihrab and he was leading prayers. And when the Salah got over, Rasulullah himself, he stood and he said that, where is this Bedouin? He had a question for me. He says, I've got one question. Okay, pose this question. He says that, Aina Mata Yawmus Sa'ah? My question is that, when will Qiyamah take place? Now this is a very hard question, isn't it? Even in Quran, Allah says that the knowledge of Qiyamah only Allah has, according to Quran. So he says that, when will Qiyamah take place? Rasulullah asked him a question. He says that, what did you prepare yourself for Qiyamah? If you're asking me, when will Qiyamah take place? How did you prepare yourself for Qiyamah? So he said that, Ya Rasulullah, I don't have anything particular that I can be proud of. But yes, I've got these normal things. I've got salah and fasting and all. But I can assure you one thing, that Ya Rasulullah, I love you and your family. I've got love for you and your family. On hearing this, riwaya says, فَتَبَسَّمَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Rasulullah smiled and he said that, الْمَرْءُ مَعَ مَنْ أَحَبَّهُ. Rasulullah says that, do know, Al-mar'u ma'aman ahabba. We'll connect the second khutbah. The same hadith, even Imam Ridha said about Imam Hussein. Here Rasulullah says, he says that, do know, if you love us, Rasulullah smiled and he said, Al-mar'u ma'aman ahabba. A man will be counted, well, he will be resurrected with that entity which he likes. So even if you like a stone, if you like a pet, if you like anything, you show extra love, you show extra mawadda. Then you will be encountered and you will be resurrected with that, isn't it? So the highest degree of love should be for Ahlul Bayt. Do not sacrifice other things for Ahlul Bayt. You don't sacrifice other things. Muharram is just coming. We are approaching to the holy month of Muharram. Do not sacrifice your majalises. Do not sacrifice your namazes and all other duas. Whatever you can, give ample time to Abu Abdullah al-Hussein. Who knows that next year will we be able to grab this time or not? Maybe it is our last year. You never know. So make most of it. A'udhu billahi minash shaitani layni rajim. Bismillahi rahmani rahim. Wal asr. Innal insana lafi khusr. Illa alladhina amanu wa amilu s-salihat. Watawasaw bil haq. Watawasaw bil sabr. Amanna billah. Wa sadaqallahu al-aliyu al-azim. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين إنه خير ناصر ومعين الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين شفيع المذنبين رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى محمد والصلاة والسلام على أمير المؤمنين وسي رسول رب العالمين علي بن أبي طالب والصلاة والسلام على بنت رسول الله فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين والصلاة والسلام على إمام المسلمين سبط رحمة الحسن والحسين سيدي الشباب أهل الجنة والصلاة والسلام على علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والحجة القائم المنتظر المهدي. بقية الله خير لكم إن كنتم مؤمنين. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
In Surah Al Imran, which is the third chapter of Quran Majid, verse number 38, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the dua of Nabi Zakaria. He says that هنالك دعا زكريا, that Zakaria prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's very interesting that what was his dua? He prayed to Allah, Rabbi habli min ladunka dhurriyatan tayyiba innaka sami'ud du'a, which means that, oh Allah, grant me from you good offspring. This is one of the duas that even we should have in our duas, in our sajda shukr, that, oh Allah, grant me good offspring. Rabbi habli min ladunka dhurriyatan tayyiba. Then he ends up by saying, innaka sami'u dua, you are the hearer of the dua. Now, it was the first day of Mah Muharram, the holy month of Muharram, that when Rayyan bin Shabib goes to visit our eighth holy imam, it happened so. Rayyan bin Shabib was the companion of our eighth holy imam. When he goes to visit the eighth holy imam, the eighth holy imam poses a question to Rayyan bin Shabib. And he says that, oh Rayyan, are you fasting today? So he says that no. Imam says that I'm fasting today. Then imam continues. Imam says that, oh Rayyan, today is the first day of the holy month of Muharram. And it is the day when Zakaria's dua was accepted. Zakaria was blessed with Yahya. So then Imam continues. Imam says that whoever fasts on the first day of Muharram and prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he has got a legitimate desire, a legitimate wish, and he prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his hajat will be accepted, Imam Rida says. Then Imam says that it was today, the first day of Muharram, that he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Zakaria, he says that Rabbi habli min ladunka dhurriyatan tayyiba innaka sami'ud du'a, oh Allah, grant me good offspring, and you are the hearer of the prayer. And when he prayed this, the angels called out to Zakaria while Zakaria was standing in his mihrab, and they said that, oh Zakaria, you are blessed with Yahya. Now according to Quran says that it is a name that nobody was given this name. It was a unique name given to the son of Zakaria, and that is Yahya. You have never heard this name before. It is a unique name. The angels tell him that you will be blessed with Yahya. Then the angels continue. They say that, which Yahya? Sayyidun wa hasuran wa nabiyya. He will be honorable, yani sayyida. He will be honorable, he will be hasura, he will be chaste, and he will be a prophet. So the dua of Zakaria was accepted. He said that, I want good offspring. The dua was accepted. Then Allah says that, and he will be amongst the good ones. He will be from the good ones. He will be min as-salihin, Allah says. Then Imam Rizal alayhi salam continues. Imam says that just as Zakaria's dua was fulfilled on the first day of Muharram, any mu'min prays to Allah on the first day of Muharram and fasts, his wish will be fulfilled. And then Imam Rida continues. It's a very interesting riwayah of Imam Rida alayhi salam, a beautiful conversation between Imam Rida alayhi salam and the son of Shabib, Yabna Shabib. Imam says that, Yabna Shabib, Muharram is the month that at the age of ignorance, during the period of Jahiliyyah, the Bedouin, the ignorant Arabs would respect this month due to its sanctity. And they would forbid fighting, they would forbid bloodshed, they would forbid killing each other. Then Imam says, but curse be on this nation, Imam Rida says, curse be on Banu Umayyah, that neither they respected the holy month, this holy sanctuary, due to its sanctity, nor did they respect the holy prophet. They killed the grandson of the holy prophet. Then Imam continues. Imam says that they killed the prophet's grandson, and then the women folk of the holy prophet were taken as captives, and they plundered their belongings. Then Imam says, may Allah's curse be on them. O son of Shabib, Imam Rida continues, he says that if you wish to cry for anyone or for anything, then cry for Hussein ibn Ali. Imam Rida says, cry for Hussein ibn Ali, for he was martyred like a sheep, like an animal. He was slaughtered like a sheep. 18 of his family members, unmatched, unparalleled on the face of this earth, were also martyred. Imam continues. Imam says that the seven heavens cried for Al-Hussein ibn Ali, and they rained blood, and the earth wept, the sands became red, Imam says, for Hussein ibn Ali. Then Imam Rida alayhi salam continues. He says that 4,000 angels descended from the heavens, and they said to Allah on the day of Ashura that, O Allah, give us an opportunity to go and aid Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam, to go and assist Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam. And these 4,000 angels, when they prayed to Allah, Allah permitted them. That is why in our ziyarah, inshallah, this time in Maah Muharram, my first 12 ashra, the first 12 nights of Maah Muharram, Ashra Ula, the topic will be tafsir of ziyarat Ashura. And you will find that in ziyarat Ashura, Imam Sadiq alayhi salam teaches us. What does he say? He says, when you greet, see, one imam teaches us to greet other imam. He says, greet Hussein by saying, Assalamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah wa alal arwahillati hallat bi finaik. Those, peace be upon Aba Abdullah and upon the spirits who sacrificed on Aba Abdullah. Now this arwah, it is also the 72 martyrs of Karbala, and it is also applicable. It is also applicable to the spirits, to the angels, those 4,000 angels who prayed to Allah on the day of Ashura. It is also applicable to these ruh, arwah, wa alal arwah illati hallat bi finaik. Those ruh came on the day of Ashura. Then Imam Rida says that by the time when they came to the plains of Karbala, Hussein alayhi salam was already martyred. When they reached there, they martyred, and they started to weep, and they started to cry. They shouted with their slogans, and Imam Rida says that they will be there dusty till the rise of Al-Qaim. They'll be there, these 4,000 angels, and they will be there. Then Imam continues. Imam says that whenever you weep over the affliction of Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam, your sins will be forgiven, be it big or small. Imam says, few or numerous, your sins will be forgiven. Now, I'll say something in the bracket. I remember when we were in Qum, our asatid would say, on the days of Muharram, that when you go for majalis of Hussein, when you cry, and when tears flow from your eyes, and when the tears flow towards your cheeks, at that time, you pray to Allah your hajat. Your hajats are being accepted. Imam Rida says that the sins are being forgiven. Then Imam continues. Imam says, O the son of Shabib, if you wish to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a pure state, free of sin, then you do ziyarat of Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam. Do ziyarat. Sometimes we take this ziyarat very lightly, don't we? Alhamdulillah, we are blessed, and Allah has given us tawfiq that every Sundays we do recite a ziyarah here, ziyarat Ashura, every Sundays, isn't it? Be it raining or sunshine, whatever. In any case, be it summer or winter, we do pray here ziyarat of Imam Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam. But the maqam of ziyarat of Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam, we have not understood. Ulamas are saying it is like a banquet. It is like a feast. It is like a buffet. That you get everything in this. It is Hadith-e-Qudsi. It is Ma'adub-e-Ilahiyya. Others say that it is Hadith-e-Qudsi. It is from Imam Sadiq alayhi salam indeed, but it has come from Allah. And Imam Sadiq has taught it to his companions. Then Imam continues, Imam Ridha alayhi salam says to the son of Shabib, if you want to abide in the palaces of the paradises, then, and with the Holy Prophet and his holy family, then, Imam Ridha says, then you curse upon the murders of Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam. Then Imam continues that if you wish to earn the reward of the martyrs of Karbala who sacrificed their lives with Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam, then say only this sentence. Say, Ya laytani kuntu ma'akum fa'afuza fawzan azima. Which means that if only I had been with them, so that I would have attained the great felicity. Imam Ridha says. Then Imam continues. Imam says that, O the son of Shabib, if you desire to be with us in the highest degree of paradise, then grieve in our sorrows. Rejoice in our happiness. Remain attached to our love. For even if a person loves a stone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall resurrect him with that stone. Al-mar'u ma'aman ahabba. On these days that we are very, very close to the holy month of Muharram, when we approach to the holy month of Muharram, we all know that Zilhajj itself is a sacred month. There are four sacred months: Zilqa'dah, Zilhijjah, Muharram, and the holy month of Rajab. Now we started from Zilqa'dah, then Zilhijj and Muharram. These all days which we are going through continuously, consecutively, these are blessed days. We, especially in this time, on the day of Friday, just after khutbah, before Salat al-Jumma, we should not forget the first du'as we pray for our Muslim brothers, for our Shias, who are going through very tough time. Indeed, in this age and time, Shias are going through very difficult moments. Four children have been killed and another wounded in bomb explosion in Afghanistan, in eastern province of Afghanistan, which is called Wardak, in a village of Salar. And how were they killed? Amazing. See, the Shias now, they are treated in a very bad way. Now, it's just too much. When you see the media, I was just thinking this morning that what should I say? The atrocities and the oppression which takes place in Iraq or in Syria, in Bahrain or in Afghanistan, you'll find that Shias are going through very difficult times. They were given four children, these minor victims, they were given bombs. That device was switched off. Device was switched off. And it was automatically set. That a time came when it switched on, it blew them. And four minor children were killed. Imagine, this is the situation. And then you will find that in this moment, let us pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the wasila of Imam Hussein alayhi salam and his companions, that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant peace in Iraq, in Afghanistan, in Bahrain, in Syria, all those places where there's no peace, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spread peace. Lastly, let us pray for all mu'minin wal mu'minat, especially for the nephew of Sayyid Ali Imran, who is known as Sayyid Shaji Hussein Kazmi, is very sick. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him quick recovery. Surah Mubarakat al-Fatiha, Shifa'i Marza. Mu'mineen are reminded of the 40th Chaliswa Majlis of Barkat Bhai Walji's father and Zera Banu Bhai Danji's father, which will take place tomorrow in Peterborough. All the details are there in Friday supplement. If I'm not mistaken, Namaz starts at 4:45. Soon after Namaz Maghribin, the Chaliswa program will start in Peterborough. And Mu'mineen are also informed about the Chaliswa Majlis of Marhuma Farwa Khatun Naqvi, mother of Sayyid Muhammad Naqvi, will inshallah take place on Sunday, 3rd of November, after Zuhrain prayers at Birmingham. Lastly, let us pray for all mu'minin wal mu'minat. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Allahumma ighfir lil mu'minin wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. Tabi' baynana wa baynahum bil khairat. Innaka mujibud da'awat. Innaka ala kulli shay'in qadir. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللئيم الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن علي ولي الله أشهد أن علي حجة الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح حي على خير العمل حي على خير العمل قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يسبح لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض الملك القدوس العزيز الحكيم هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين وآخرين منهم لما يلحقوا بهم وهو العزيز الحكيم ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا بئس مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآيات الله والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين قل يا أيها الذين هادوا إن زعمتم أنكم أولياء لله من دون الناس فتمنوا الموت إن كنتم صادقين ولا يتمنونه أبدا بما قدمت أيديهم والله عليم بالظالمين قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم ثم تردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون فإذا قضيت الصلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون وإذا رأوا تجارة أو لهوا انفضوا إليها وتركوك قائما قل ما عند الله خير من اللهو ومن التجارة والله خير الرازقين الله أكبر اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم إنا عبيدا من عبادك الصالحين قاموا بكتابك وسنة نبيك فاجزهم أن خير الجزاء. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده رب اسم الله على محمد وآل محمد. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده رب اسم الله على محمد وآل محمد. الله أكبر. أستغفر الله ربي وأتوب إليه. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده رب اسم الله على محمد وآل محمد. الله أكبر. بحول الله وقوته أقوم وأقعد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده رب صل على محمد وآل محمد. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم اجعلني في مقامي هذا صلوات ورحمة ومغفرة. اللهم اجعل محياي محيا محمد وآل محمد ومماتي ممات محمد وآل محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده رب اسم الله على محمد وآل محمد. الله أكبر. أستغفر الله ربي وأتوب إليه. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده يا لطيف إرحم عبدك الضيف. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا إله إلا الله إلها واحدا ونحن له مسلمون. لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره المشركون. لا إله إلا الله ربنا ورب آبائنا الأولين. لا إله إلا الله وحده 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 أنجز وحده ونسر أبدان وعز جندا وعزم الأحزاب وحدا فله الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت ويميت ويحيي وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير اللهم صل على محمد وعلى
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان العين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد الحمد لله الأول قبل الإنشاء والإحياء والآخر بعد فناء الأشياء العليم الذي لا ينسى من ذكره ولا ينقص من شكره ولا يخيب من دعاه ولا يقطع رجاء من رجاه اللهم إني أشهدك وكفى بك شهيدا وأشهد جميع ملائكتك والسكان سماواتك وحملة عرشك ومن بعثت من أنبيائك ورسلك ونشأت من أصناف خلقك أني أشهد أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت وحدك لا شريك لك ولا عديل ولا خلف لقولك ولا تبديل وأن محمدا صلى الله عليه وآله عبدك ورسولك عدم ما حملته إلى العباد وجاهد في الله عز وجل حق الجهاد وأنه بشر بما هو حق من الثواب وأنذر بما هو صدق من العقاب اللهم ثبتني على دينك ما أحييتني ولا تزغ قلبي بعد إذ هديتني وهب لي من لدنك رحمة منا إنك أنت الوهاب صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد واجعلني من أتباعه والشيعة واحشرني في زمرته ووفقني لأداء فرض الجمعات وما أوجبت علي فيها من الطاعات وقسمت لأهلها من العطاء في يوم الجزاء إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن علي ولي الله أشهد أن علي حجة الله هيا للصلاة هيا للصلاة هيا للفلاح هيا للفلاح هيا